In society, I believe everyone knows that there's different ways to learn a lesson. We can see something and learn something from it. We can listen to something and learn something from it. And I believe the recent situation of how the Patriotic Alliance leaders reacted to Miss South Africa and Chidema is really a great lesson for us as a country, that social media is not real life. And whatever you read on social media might not be true. It might be and it might not be true. And social media, everything you see trending there doesn't mean it's facts, doesn't mean it's truth. So that's a lesson I believe as the whole country we have learned. And majority of the people I believe who really need to learn this lesson is people who are invested in opening YouTube channels and reporting news or just speaking about anything. You can't speak about things that you're not sure of. You can't conclude information as fact without you verifying, without you making sure it's really fact. So journalists, upcoming YouTubers, or anyone who maybe wants to write something or want to speak about anyone or anything, it's a lesson that you can't say things without being sure whatever you're saying is true. And not just say it, you can't attack someone based on false information. You can't attack someone based on unverified information just because it's trending and there's an agenda between what is trending. So you can't attack someone based on just hatred and taking your hatred towards Nigerians and fueling it with misinformation and thinking that your attack is gonna hold value. It don't hold value. That's why when you see Mr. Kenny Kunene went into a debate, SABC debate, with a VIT student, a young girl, a young woman, probably half his age. She was so calm, she was so relaxed. He was overreacting based on false information, things that are not factual, because somehow he hates foreigners, somehow he hates Nigerians. It doesn't work like that. It doesn't work like that, and it will just create a society whereby everything will just speak based on lies. The truth won't matter. And I don't want to live in that society. That's why I'm always against misinformation, false information. I'm always against lies. That's why I make sure when I speak about something, there's verification. I put up tweets of the things I'm speaking about. Or if there's a clip I have to post, I also upload the post, the clip, so you guys can see and hear for yourself. And then I continue speaking, because I want you guys to know that I'm an honest researcher. I'm an honest reporter of news. I don't just say things where when you Google, you don't find the things I'm talking about. You can only find them trending. Nah. So I don't want to be that type of person. And I also don't want to live in a society like that, because I don't want to live in a society based of lies. I don't want to live in a society where people lie for engagement, social media trends, and just those things only. Nah, so it's a lesson for many, and it's a lesson that everyone needs to look at and actually learn something from it, because there's a lot to learn. I also learned a lot as a YouTuber myself from that situation. I learned to present myself properly in a debate. Like, plenty of things I'll explain one day. One day when I have time, I'll explain. But in the meantime, yeah, it's a great lesson we have learned.